Hey guys, so how's everybody today? So today it is Thursday, August 3rd, and it's the afternoon. And so I got an early morning shift today, and I got a short shift today, and I got a short break today, and I came home, and I'm hungry. So today, for late lunch, I got these Philly steak pockets things, and you just do it in the microwave. And so these are similar to Pizza Pops, but they are made by a different brand. And all you do is you just cook it in the microwave and off you go. And so when I went to the store, I know they got their pizza flavors and pepperoni and stuff like that. And I have never seen this flavor before. It is the Philly steak cheese flavor. Really, really nice, actually. Oh, I'm hungry and exhausted. Oh. And also, if you guys notice, I had a shower this morning and my hair is very nice and puffy. Not this week, but the next time, the 2 weeks, I'm definitely gonna be needing a haircut soon, but not right away. You guys know, if you guys have been following me for a while, you guys know that I have left my hair way longer before. Good old Coca-Cola, yes, I stocked up on my best friend. The landlord is actually very nice. The landlord took me out shopping yesterday because he was wanting to go out to shopping. And so, hey, why not? So it saves me on the Uber, so I don't have to take Uber. Boy, it's a very weird day today because I had an early shift today. And this morning, the reason I was able to wake up was because there was a cold breeze this morning. It was like 10 degrees this morning. And then it went up to like 26 degrees now. It's really, really hot weather. And when I was walking back home from the train station, I was like in a sauna. I was like done for the day. My hair looks really, really nice today. I don't know why. I use the exact same shampoo. I have not changed the shampoo. Happy Thursday to you guys. And so for Alberta, it is the Heritage Day long weekend. So I do not know if other places have it. So hope you guys are going to have a wonderful long weekend. I'm going to be working the long weekend. So like, I never really understand what Heritage Day is all about anyway. So it's like, I'm not like, woohoo, party. Or some people, they go camping. Let's go camping. I am not a camping kind of guy. You guys know, it's like, no way, Jose. You guys can deal with the mosquitoes if you guys like, but not me. I am perfectly fine in the city. So, the crazy stuff that everybody's been bitching about since yesterday. Like, the last 1 or 2 weeks, our gas prices, it's been very cheap. It was like around 85.40 cents a liter. I am Canadian, we are Canadian here, and we charge per liter the gasoline at the gas station. And so everybody was like, yeah, so cheap, so cheap. And so all of a sudden yesterday morning, it jumped 20 cents and it's like now like 105.40 cents or something. And everybody is bitching about that. What are the gas prices like in your area? Because me and Matthew, because when we went to the USA for traveling, you guys have very, very cheap gasoline prices down in the US compared to Canadian prices. So let's start with the show and tell. And so, because I honestly haven't done a shopping in a few weeks, and so the landlord went to Costco yesterday, and so I was like, hey, why not? Let's go to Costco too. And so I was looking for granola bars or some bars or something to munch on, because you guys, no, it's like on the way to work and stuff like that. I usually like to grab a granola bar on the way. I was gonna be grabbing a protein bar because they were the biggest box available. The Costco brand of the protein bars has like maybe 20 or 22 bars in the box. However, I saw this stuff here. These are fruit and nut bars. I have never seen this brand before, and it's the Vel, V-E-L brand. These are very, very delicious looking fruit and nut bars, and they got three flavors in the pack. And these are as natural as you can go with the granola bar world. And they actually do not use any aspartame or sucralose or any of the nasty sugars out there. And they actually use honey for the putting everything all together. They use honey. So I have been addicted to granola bars since yesterday, and I've been eating these since yesterday. And for a while now, I've been giving up on buying the good old Quaker stuff. The Quaker bars, they have been pissing me off. Because the Quaker bars are so small. They are like smaller than the size of your finger. It's like bite size, like crazy. Drives me crazy. But these are really, really good. It's like, I think these are organic too. These are gluten-free source of fiber, and they say it's naturally sweetened, no sugar added. And so these bars are very, very good. So if you guys see these, you should try it. But I do not know if the American viewers can find it, because this stuff is made in Canada. So I do not know if you guys can able to find it. And when I got home, I had a granola bar right away because I was so hungry. And the heat was making me so tired and drained. And so it lifted me up a little bit when I had a granola bar. However, if you guys are into the calorie count, it is 200 calories per bar. 200 calories per bar. OMG. But I think the calories, it comes from the nuts and the almonds and stuff like that, that they put in it. So I think it is all the healthy calories. It is not like the calories that you get from McDonald's or when you eat Big Mac or something or stuff like this. I really, really, really like this stuff, guys. You should really check the stuff out. Yeah. When I came home today, I was wanting to make something else for lunch, but it was so hot, I was not in the mood to do it. So I just decided to make these, and it's in the microwave, so it only takes 3 minutes in the microwave, so it's very, very handy dandy to have this type of stuff in the freezer. Really, really nice stuff. The next thing that's been happening is because I do not know why I got this luck with the phone chargers. My phone charger that I got with my Samsung phone right now, it is starting to be very, very messed up. And this is my the Samsung charger that I have at the moment. And right now, it is hanging on by some tape. That's how bad it is. And I don't know if you guys can see how badly cracked and all that shit, and it's even bent. I do not know how my phone chargers can get that bad. Can you guys see how badly bent and broken? Can you guys see that? I hope you guys can see. Look at this phone charger, guys. I am so surprised there is no electric fire yet because of this. Like, look at this. Like, OMG. Can you guys see how bent and messed up my phone charger is? So, I was really dreading it, and I was not wanting to make a stop out to the cell phone store to go buy a phone charger. And at the grocery store that I usually go to, they sell everything these days. And so I remembered that they sell the phone chargers. And so I bought me one of these, and they say it's for Android devices too. It says it on there. So I hope it's gonna work, and so there will be no electric fire. So I am very terrified at the thought of electric fire. It's like, have you guys ever experienced an electric fire before in your house or anywhere that you have gone before? So let me know in the comments below. It is so scary thought, the electric fire. They are loaded with steak. Like today, I was wanting to be a lazy bitch today, and so I was wanting to buy a hot meal at the grocery store on the way, but it's like, I thinking, it's like, I already spent way too much money this last few weeks, like dealing with the moving and stuff like that, like OMG, you guys will be so scared of me, scared for me. So, I remembered that I had these in the freezer, so I was like, I'll just go home and microwave these in the microwave. I am capable of microwaving for 3 minutes in the microwave. I think I am. Oh, and about my yesterday's mukbang video when I did the sticky rice. When I went out for dinner with my parents yesterday. Thank you so much, everybody, again, for your support. And so, thank you, everybody, for the wonderful comments. And thank you, everybody, for the thumbs up. And yesterday, I was on Fluffy's live stream yesterday, and it is like, it made me feel so wonderful because Fluffy was saying that she worries about me if I don't make a video in a few days and stuff like that. It's like, it is so nice that doing the YouTube and stuff like that, and I got people thinking about me thousands of miles away, and people that I've never met in real life before thinking about me, and so thank you so much, everybody, lately for all your thumbs up and stuff like that, because lately my 6 or 8 videos that I've done, I've been getting over 20 or 30 likes, the thumbs up in my videos. So thank you so much, everybody, for your support. It is really nice to see that. So thank you so much. And the last thing that I want to show you guys is this. You guys remember? I talked about it in one of my live streams with Angie on YouTube, and she delivered. And she actually did the bunnies and carrots painting. So, thank you so much, Angie, on YouTube. You do a great job, as always. And so, thank you so much. My, look at these carrots. Can you guys get the picture? Look at that carrots there. And so, it is in a box that is in my parents' house right now, and so I do got a picture frame for it, but I have to go to my parents' house to get it, and so it is gonna be framed and stuff like that soon, and so thank you so much, Angie on YouTube. I am feeling a lot better now because, like, when I got home, I just felt so drained. I felt so drained. You guys have no idea. Coca-Cola's the best thing ever. Like, this product, like, I never understood why they put it there because, they include you this a cardboard insert or something and you're supposed to put it in here and carry it around with you or something. I never use that stuff, so I never understand the design behind that. And the other thing that is annoying is that talking about the Heritage Day long weekend, I just saw the memo on the Calgary Transit, the electric notice board. And so again, they are doing maintenance or something during the long weekend, and I'm going to be needing to take the shuttle bus or something. So annoying. Every single long weekend, the Calgary Transit has to do some type of maintenance. Maintenance drives me mad. These are really tasty. It is probably the cheap steak that they use, but they actually loaded them up pretty good. Oh, and I'm talking about bunnies. I was maybe thinking about looking for some bunnies or something for later today or something, but then the weather, oh my gosh, it just got so hot weather. It's like, no way, Jose, I'm not gonna do any of that today. It's gonna be like a sauna disaster. No bunnies today. It's too hot for that. I would just rather relax for the rest of the afternoon and not be bothered and have a siesta and stuff like that. And yeah. I could not be bothered with bunnies today. It's too hot for that. But maybe for wherever you guys are from, maybe the 26 degrees is a normal weather for you guys. But for me, it is way too hot. Way, way too hot. Actually, in my opinion, I think since I grew up here in Canada my whole life, I would rather prefer the weather to be minus 30 in the winter when it's snowing and when it's blizzard. I like the cold weather, actually. Alright guys, so lunch is done and lunch was delicious, very, very easy lunch. I just microwave it in the microwave for 3 minutes and so yeah. And so thank you so much everybody for tuning in today and I hope you guys enjoyed and I hope you guys are enjoying the weather wherever you guys are. Don't forget to check out the playlist of all my other older videos on my channel. And I will see you guys very soon.